This is a Hungarian accent that you are listening to. I hope it's okay. Can you understand what I'm saying? I'm not talking in Chinese. Very good, very good, very good. Excellent, excellent. I think that the way how you do your best, how can you be even more expressive? Because what is the goal of music making? To create sound that is very expressive. What is expressive will attract more people, and you get more excitement, more success, you will be more fueled to play even more. Isn't it? This is the circle. And the good news, this is a lifelong process. My first concert was in 1978 that was recorded, and it was 38 years ago, and I'm more and more excited about making music. And what I just try to prepare you for, the more variety you have, the more success you will have. The more the articulation of contrasts you have, the more level of contrast you will observe, the more you will enjoy that. The more challenge you will have to take, but it will be worth, because your performance will be more colorful. How many levels of contrasts can we come up with to make music? Because what makes music interesting, everyone knows contrast, is it right? Contrasts. What kind of contrasts we have? Tell me, please. Let's go for the very first one. Very first. What is the number one task for a group that your conductor does for you? To give a tempo, isn't it? Tempo. Tempo is number one. Everything is tempo. Why? Because we have tempo in our inter life, isn't it? Everyone has a heart inside of you. You have a metronome, boom, boom, boom. There is a tempo for everyone given. When you just sit on the earth, you will see a tempo, because every day there is a new day. So there is a tempo. A new day is coming every day after 24 hours. So there is a tempo number one that you have to come up with as contrast, slow or fast. And if you play always everything the same tempo, after a while nobody will listen to you because you are boring. And what is the other level of contrast that you have to think about? Somebody said already here. Dynamics, soft, loud. Very good, very good. Next one, keep going. Because this is that I would like to bring you a little bit deeper in. Articulation, guys, articulation. Articulation in string instruments. What is the main idea, a source of articulation? The different bowings, is it right? Yeah. You are scared to death to get off of a string. You're always on the string. You are not. You are afraid to come off for a little bit. There's a big martella to one martelli. You are not leaving the string. You feel insecure with that. So try to learn more type of bow strokes to make your performance more colorful. Rhythm, everything is good. You play the right notes. They have a little intonation issues with the E flat, but it's not easy. There is nothing to do with preparation of that. And you have right rhythm, you have right tempo, everything. The colorfulness, richness, variety of the different bow strokes. This is that I didn't feel. How can you make influence in your instruments for the dynamics? How many ways you have a string player to play louder or softer? Anyone? Bow speed influences your dynamics. What else? Bow pressure. Very good. Two. Give me one more. Bow placement. Is it right? Where is it louder? Where is it softer? Tell me. Well, when you are closer to the bridge, it will project more. Why? Guys, everything is related to everything. You as the young human beings, you are in school, you are studying a lot. Make sure that you are not putting the subject in boxes in your brain. Everything is related to everything. Do you study physics? So, what? You don't study physics? But you study physics. Who studies here physics? Very smart. You all should learn. You all should study the physics. Why am I saying that? I mentioned for you that if you want to play louder, you have to go closer to the bridge. Why? What is the function of the bridge? Who knows? What is the function of the bridge in your instrument?
Travels the sound down into the sound.
No?
Rocks.
What is the main function of the bridge? The bridge is who conveys the resonance of your string to the resonator box beneath of your strings to magnify your sound. So this is the transition. This is where the resonance goes to the box. So if you are closer, you go more directly to the box, so you will have bigger sound. If you are closer to the fingerboard, a less chance to get projected. So this is a third level possibility to project more sound, both speed, pressure, and the placement of the ball. This is that I would like to make some experiments with you to give you some ideas. Let's see those big crescendo. This is the Arlington sketches. Let's go to bar 31. Your wrists were really good, very nice, quick, but I didn't feel that from piano we went to fortissimo. How many dynamical levels we have between piano and fortissimo? How many dynamical levels we have between piano and fortissimo? What is the next after piano? Mezzo piano. What is after mezzo piano? Mezzo forte. What after mezzo forte? Forte. What after forte? Well, you still can have poco forte, which means more than forte and fortissimo. Let's say just that with this what you listed. How many levels? Five. I didn't hear five. I heard just something and a little more. No, five levels higher. How many bars you have to get from piano to fortissimo? At 31, you are piano, is it right? One bar later starts the crescendo, so it's still piano, but you start to change the dynamics. After you have 33, after you have 34, and you are fortissimo at 35. How many bars is there? Wow, you study mathematics too. You are so good, not only physics. Very good. You see, everything is related to everything. How many notes you have to play in one beat?
Four.
Very good. You start with a very tiny wrist gesture, is it right? And grow with it. Grow with it. Put more and more bow, more and more energy, and because you have more space, you have to increase the speed of the bow, is it right? Because when you have that tiny space, just a little movement. When you have that big space, you have to move very fast. It takes a lot of energy, but I promise, it's worth. Let's try that, okay? Let's start from 31. Let's start from 31. Where is your bow when you start? In the middle? Where is it? Mm-hmm. Very good. You start at the fingerboard. I like that. I like that, what they are doing. Let's all of us do this. Mm-hmm. At the tip of, very good. Closer to the tip of the bow. You can go also lower a little bit. Here we start. Very good. Very good. Very good. Also, just move. Mm-hmm. Wow. You never played like this. This is how you can start and how you grow with it. Also, let's start with that third of the bow. Mm-hmm. 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 And after we use more and more space, more and more bow, and come closer to the bridge. Very good. So here, taga 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 taga. Let's start. And one and two and three and four. Take it, 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 take it. More and more, more and more, more and more, more and. Very good. What do you think? What dynamical level we arrived to? It was no more than 40. Have you had breakfast today morning? I can hear that. Imagine that you won't get breakfast if you don't play fortissimo. Here we are. Let's try one more time. So you have to play if you are hungry. One more time. Softer start and use more and more bow. It's too much. You can't go that close. Just like this, okay? Very good. One, two, three, four. Check it, check it, check it, check it, check it, check it. Can you do twice as much energy? Just that part. 35. Everyone, 35. 1, 2, 35. More, a little more. I can hear his sound, but I still don't hear enough here. Just put on the bow and more bow. Use interbow very quickly. 1, 2, 3, 4. Very good. Don't come off of that. Keep it. Push it on. Push the bow on the string. Plus, speed it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we start to sound. Now let's start again. 31. Pianissimo. upper third of the bow, upper third, one, two, three, four. Jacka, 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 jacka. More, more, more pressure, more pressure, more pressure. Quicker, quicker, more speed, and speed. Good. Do you feel the difference? You feel it now? You change the color, everything? I still don't feel that you had the target in your mind. When you start the piano, you already have to know where are we going to 35, and gradually more, and more, and more, and more. So now that you don't need to focus on the fingering, because you already know how to play those notes, try to focus harder of the bow. Use more and more. Keep the same character, just give more and more pressure on it. Let's try one more. One, two, three, and one. It's too much, it's too much, too much, too much. Let's piano. Piano. One, two, three, and more, more. Press, press, pressure, more. Quicker, quicker, more. Very good, very good, very good. So this is one of the ways. Learn the exercise, great.
Yeah.
Let's go to the beginning. Let's go to the beginning. Let's go to the very beginning. Same piece. And then cello and bass. Yeah, I don't try. I don't. You have to release. You need release. Wah, 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 wah. You go, oh. No, we need a little release also of the song. The instruments were invented to imitate human voice. And this is a percussive repeating rhythm. And your wonderful conductor is a percussionist. So he knows that when you start a note, that's it. In a drum, you don't have a long note. You just hit, and this is how long it will be. This is a percussive rhythm here. Are you afraid to come off of the string? Wom, 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 wom. And you can play shorter notes if you come off of the string. You have you ever played like that? He asked you not to do that. It's more safe. He's absolutely right. He's absolutely right. It's more safe. It will be more characteristic if you, you know, the composer says with vigor. What does it mean with vigor? With vigor. What does it mean? His musical terminology at the beginning. You see. What else does it mean vigor? There you go. Liveliness. Not like dead people. You try. Dead people don't dance. This is dance music. We need a little more life. We need a little more percussive sound. Try it, okay? Try it. One, two, and. Very good. Can you do quicker wrist movement on the eighth? One, one, one. Quicker wrist for the eighth notes. One, two, three, and. One, two, and. Very good. A little more pressure for the eighth note, double bass too. A little more. Balance the two instruments. Let's try. Cello and bass. One, two, three, and. Two, and. Don't rush. I didn't ask you to rush. I asked you to put more pressure and release. Wow, 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 wow. More pressure and more release with your wrist. Not just an even pressure. But releases with your wrist. One, two, three, and. And. I start to like that. Do you hear the difference?
Yes.
It starts to sound like a dance music, isn't it? And not dead people's dance. People who are living, they like to dance more, isn't it? Here we are, let's try everyone from the beginning. Try to do the same way, 1/2 minute. One, two, bass, start. And. More press, and release. Very good. 15. how long it's written? Different than the first one, the D? No, but you play totally different. You play the D long and you play the A short. Why? Quarter note should be same bow length, same bow amount. Show me just that, 15. Cello and bass, 15. D and A, same bow amount. 1, 2, 3. Very good. Can you put a little more pressure on the bow in the double bass? 1, 2, 3, D, A. And you see, now it starts to get alive. Start to get alive. More characteristics, more kind of bowings. This is my suggestion. Practice detachés, staccatos, ricochets, everything. Practice a little more. Just do scales with different bow techniques and after apply those old music. It's worth, because you are very talented. You play great music, you have a wonderful teacher who knows what to do with you. You are very young, beautiful, healthy, so keep practicing and more variety, more contrast. This will make your performance more colorful. Thank you very much for the attention and the chance to work with you. Congratulations.